Good evening. We begin tonight with breaking news on a COVID scare linked to the Royal Children's Hospital. Let's head live to Dougal Beattie. Dougal, take us through what you know.
Pete, Nine News understands that a doctor who worked at the Royal Children's Hospital has contracted COVID-19. It is thought that he acquired the virus through a household contact that is linked to the Mount Alexander College cluster. Now, we have been able to confirm that the doctor was not working at the Royal Children's Hospital while he was infectious, but investigations are still underway into his movements when he was working next door at the private clinics at 48 Flemington Road. That is still a concern because there are common areas between the private clinics and the Royal Children's Hospital. They are now working with health authorities to determine if there has been any public exposure sites, and we are awaiting an update on this developing story tonight. This all comes on a day when Victoria recorded 20 new local cases.
Two lanes of vehicles snaked around a testing site in Melbourne's west, but there's one suburb where authorities fear COVID could be circulating.
The area of most concern to us today is Caroline Springs.
So far, 25 cases have been linked to the CS Square shopping centre. Only 400 tests were recorded in Caroline Springs yesterday after two pop-up testing centres were quickly established. Today, the COVID response commander called for action.
We need to see more people in the Caroline Springs area coming forward for testing. It's a busy, important shopping centre.
Of today's cases, 10 are linked to CS Square, plus a second workplace connected to the Jolly Miller Cafe. Three are associated with the Newport Football Club. A further three are linked to Mount Alexander College, living in the Flemington Towers. Two are household contacts of the original Hobson's Bay family cluster, and one is an Altaqua student. Among today's numbers are two people who visited the shopping centre, but how they contracted Delta remains unclear.
We do know they went to CS Square. What we don't know yet is whether it was a fleeting transmission, perhaps in one of the common areas related to the toilets somewhere else.
By late this afternoon, five new Tier 1 exposure sites have been added across the western suburbs, including cafes, restaurants, a bus route and public bathrooms, as authorities race to get ahead of the outbreak.
There are certainly other cases out there in Melbourne that have not yet come to light.
20 new cases were recorded today. Five were in quarantine for their entire infectious period. That proportion of cases in isolation jumping from 0 to 25% in 3 days, but still unlikely to be 100% contained by the end of lockdown on Thursday.
I don't know what the future brings. The crystal ball hasn't fired up lately.
Dougal Beattie, Nine News.
Victoria Police is hoping the threat of massive fines will keep cooped-up Melburnians from making a break for it and escaping lockdown. Reid Butler's just north of Sunbury tonight. Reid, how's this being enforced?
Well, there's no ring of steel this time, Pete. Instead, police are opting for a more stealth approach, more random. They want to catch out anyone from Melbourne who's made it across the metropolitan border and into the greener pastures of regional Victoria. What does that metropolitan border look like? Well, this will give you a bit of an idea. I'm standing in the city of Hume right now, just north of Sunbury, and technically I'm in lockdown, but I take a couple of steps forward and I'm in the Massenden Ranges Shire and I'm free. It may have only been a handful of steps, but it makes a world of difference when it comes to police enforcement.
The divided state of Victoria, 200 police officers armed with number plate technology, their mission, stop Melburnians skipping town.
If you want to have Victoria Police pounce on you, then fine, take a risk, but you'll be caught.
And if you are, expect a fine worth close to $5,500. This is what the government has deemed metropolitan Melbourne for the purposes of lockdown. Geelong was spared.
It's really fantastic. We've gone through so many lockdowns.
But already a scare. One of today's new cases lives in Lara, but was isolating at home during their infectious period. The greater freedoms enjoyed by regional Victoria today.
Hi, Kathy.
Are dependent on city residents staying put. At pubs and restaurants, it's up to staff to police patrons. The threat of another shutdown looms large.
We wait with bated breath every morning, waiting for the numbers to come out. But as I say, we live in fear that we could be shut down.
We wouldn't want to be back in a short, sharp lockdown in too soon a time.
Regional Victoria isn't without restrictions, though. It's more of a lockdown light here. Masks are still mandatory indoors and out, and no home visits are permitted. But in Melbourne's outer southeast, residents in the tiny town of Garfield would happily take lockdown light.
I've got two 14-year-old boys that go to school in Warragul, which is classed as regional. They go to school with these kids and sit next to them all day, every day, but they're not allowed to play footy or basketball against them on the weekends.
The town is technically part of Cardinia Shire, but locked down publican Brad Alden Brown wants it reclassified.
Dan, come on down, mate. Come and say hello and see how rural we really are.
Reid Butler, Nine News.
Three of today's infections live at the Flemington Public Housing Towers, increasing the exposure areas at the Racecourse Road complex. Stephanie Anderson's there. Steph, two buildings are now affected.
That's right, Pete. On the weekend, it was confirmed that 130 Racecourse Road was an exposure site. Today, 126 has been added to the list. Already, there was a significant response underway here. There's a dedicated vaccination clinic and also testing clinic for tower residents. And in some promising news, around two-thirds of those who've been tested so far have already come back as negative. Now, health officials don't believe that transmission has actually occurred here in the towers. Instead, they think people are becoming infected elsewhere, and this just happens to be where they live. Now, much like those previous confirmed cases, today's three new infections have already been moved off-site and they're being cared for in hotel quarantine.
There are no positive cases or no known positive cases at this point anywhere in the Flemington estate. The estate continues to be safe.
Now, as it stands tonight, three levels within these two towers are considered Tier 1 exposures. Everyone else is Tier 2. So, Pete, they just need to get tested and isolate until they get a negative result.
OK, thank you, Steph Anderson.